Praise the Lord.
Okay, hallelujah.
Shall we rise up on our feet? Close your eyes as we pray together. Almighty God, we thank you tonight. We're grateful because you have made this day to come. We know that you have an appointment with us here. And as we come to keep the appointment with you, you will bless your people in Jesus' name. I pray that mountains of problems will be rolled away. Infirmities will be taken away. Confusion and doubt will be taken away. Mighty blessings from heaven you will grant to your people in Jesus' name. Shower your blessings down today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Please have your seat. We're looking at Psalm 9, verse 9.
You
have your Bible there, Psalm 9, verse 9. It says, the Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. We come here to talk about the Lord. We come here to talk about what the Lord can do for you. We come here so that all your problems that Satan has caused in your life, the Lord himself by his power will be able to roll away. You see one characteristic of the Lord in the passage I read to you. It talks about the Lord being a refuge. A refuge to the people that are oppressed. And
it
talks of times of trouble. Isaiah says the same thing in chapter 25. Isaiah 25 verse 4. For thou hast been a strength to the poor. A strength from the storm. A shadow from the heat. When the blast of the terrible ones is as a storm against the wall. Bringing those two verses together. The one in the Psalms and the one in Isaiah. I'm talking to you tonight on our refuge in times of storm. Our refuge in times of storm. There are different seasons in the year. In the same way, there are different seasons in the life of a man. When there is sunshine and good weather, we often do not think we need any refuge. But when the storm clouds begin to gather, when the rains begin to pour, when the flood and the winds begin to blow, when the thunder and the lightning begins to threaten, then we begin to understand the importance of a refuge. And in life, there are many people that are going through times of storm. And it comes because of different reasons in people's lives. But we want to tell you that God has provided a refuge. Although there are men that try to bring a refuge for themselves, but
we'll
discover in the message we're giving tonight the characteristics of the refuge that man will try to build for himself. And then you will see what really happens as you come to refuge under the mighty hand of the Lord. I'm going to divide the message to three parts. Number one, I'm talking about the security in God's refuge. The security in God's refuge. Maybe you know Psalm 46 already. In Psalm 46, reading from verse 1, it says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́ ìrànlọ́wọ́ ní ìgbà ìpọ́njú.
Whenever an Israelite mentioned the name of God.
Nígbàkúgbà tí ọmọ Ísírẹ́lì kan bá
dárúkọ orúkọ Ọlọ́run. A lot of things are recalled into his memory.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ nǹkan ni yóò wá sí ìrántí
rẹ̀. He will remember how they were in Egypt.
Yóò rántí bí wọ́n ṣe wà lóko ẹrú
Egypt. He will remember the protection he gave them in Egypt.
Yóò rántí ààbò tí Ọlọ́run fún wọn ní ilẹ̀
Egypt. He will remember the miracle power of God in Egypt.
Yóò rántí agbára iṣẹ́ ìyanu Ọlọ́run ní ilẹ̀ Egypt.
He will remember the provision of the Lord.
Yóò rántí ìpèsè Olúwa.
He will remember how the Lord protected the whole nation.
Yóò rántí bí Olúwa ti dáàbò gbogbo
orílẹ̀-èdè náà. Whenever a Jewish man, a Jewish woman mentioned God.
Nígbàkúgbà tí ọkùnrin tàbí obìnrin kan tí í ṣe Júù bá dárúkọ
Ọlọ́run. He will reflect on the mighty power of the Lord.
Kí alọ́kan rẹ̀ yóò rántí agbára
ńlá Ọlọ́run. And as the psalmist said, God is our refuge.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí Dávid ti sọ nínú orin yìí, ó ní Ọlọ́run ni àbò wa àti agbára.
He's talking about the people that trust in the Lord.
Ó sọ nípa àwọn tó gbẹ́kẹ̀lé Olúwa.
And they found that God is indeed a refuge.
Tí wọ́n sì ṣàwárí pé ní tòótọ́ Ọlọ́run ni àbò.
Of course, a person talking like that.
Dájúdájú ẹni tó ń sọ
orí ọ̀rọ̀ yìí. Knows of the trouble in the world.
Ó mọ̀ nípa wàhálà tí ń bẹ nínú ayé.
Of the sickness in the world.
Nípa àwọn àìsàn
tí ń bẹ nínú ayé. Of the calamities in the world.
Nípa àwọn àjálù tí ń bẹ nínú ayé. Nípa àìláàbò tí ń bẹ nínú ayé.
But he says, praise the Lord.
Gbogbo ife fi ọpẹ fún Olúwa.
There is a protection.
Àbò kan ń bẹ.
He says, praise the Lord. Ó ní
ẹyin Olúwa lógo.
There is a refuge.
Àbò kan ń bẹ.
In the times of insecurity.
Ní àkókò àìláàbò.
He says, God is our refuge and strength.
Ọlọ́run ni àbò wa àti agbára.
Then he says, it's a very present help in a time of trouble.
Ó tún wá wí pé òun gan ni lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́ ìrànlọ́wọ́ ní ìgbà ìpọ́njú.
He must have known there are times when the help comes too late.
Dájúdájú yóò mọ̀ wípé ìgbà kan wà tí ìrànlọ́wọ́ máa ń dé nígbà tó ti pẹ́ jù. Nígbà tó bá ń wojú ènìyàn.
For them to bring help unto you.
Tó retí pé kí wọ́n wá ràn ọ́ lọ́wọ́.
The help may be coming on the way.
Ìrànlọ́wọ́ wọn lè máa bọ̀ lọ́nà.
But the help never really comes when you need the help.
Ṣùgbọ́n ìrànlọ́wọ́ náà lè má dé nígbà tó nílò rẹ̀.
But he talks about the Almighty God.
Ṣùgbọ́n ní ló ń sọ nípa Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè.
And he says it's a very present help in the time of trouble.
Ó wá wí pé Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè ní lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́ ìrànlọ́wọ́ ní ìgbà ìpọ́njú.
If you're going through a storm right now.
Tí o bá ń la ìjì kọjá ní
ìsìn. The present help of the Lord is coming your way.
Ìrànlọ́wọ́ Olúwa lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́ yóò tọ̀ wá.
And tonight you will experience it in your life in Jesus' name.
Lálẹ́ yìí ó ní ìrírí rẹ̀ nínú ayé rẹ̀ ní orúkọ
Jésù. You see the conclusion of the psalmist in verse 2.
O wá rí àkójọpọ̀ ọ̀rọ̀ olórin
ìbínú ẹsẹ̀ kejì. It says, therefore, will we not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be carried into the mighty sea.
Ohun tó fi káàdì ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ̀ ní ẹsẹ̀ kejì ni pé nítorí náà ni àwa kì yóò bẹ̀rù bí a tilẹ̀ ṣe ayé ní ìdí. Tí a sì ṣí àwọn òkè ńlá ní ipò lọ sí inú
òkú.
Ó lóun yóò wù kó lè máa ṣẹlẹ̀.
The world may look like upside down.
Ó lè dàbí ẹni pé ayé dojúdé ó doríkodò.
Your little world in your little family may be upside down.
Ìgbé ayé rẹ ní ibi tó wà ní nínú ẹbí rẹ lè doríkodò.
But tonight everything will come the right side up.
Ṣùgbọ́n lálẹ́ yìí ohun gbogbo yóò padà bọ̀ sípò
fún ọ. Sickness will be taken away.
A ó mú àìsàn ayé rẹ kúrò.
The hand of the devil will be taken away.
A ó mú owó èṣù kúrò nínú ayé rẹ.
The storms in your life, everything will go away.
Gbogbo ìjì tí ń jà nínú ayé rẹ ni yóò dópin lórúkọ Jésù. Báwo la ṣe lè
sọ léyìí? What gives us the confidence for that?
Kí ló fún wa ní ìgboyà láti sọ léyìí?
He says in verse 9, he makes war to cease unto the end of the earth.
Ó sọ ní ẹsẹ̀ kẹsàn-án pé ó mú ọ̀tẹ̀ tán dé òpin ayé.
The war in your life, the trouble in your life, the Lord is going to bring everything to a stop tonight in Jesus' name.
Rògbòdìyàn, ogun àti ọ̀tẹ̀ ti ń bẹ nínú ayé rẹ, Olúwa yóò fòpin sí lálẹ́ yìí ní orúkọ Jésù.
He breaks the bow, he cuts the spear asunder, he burns the chariots in fire.
Ó ṣe ọrun. Ó sì ké ọkọ̀ méjì, ó sì fi kẹ̀kẹ́ ogun jóná.
All the weapons that the devil is using against your life is tonight everything is going to be destroyed, everything will be taken away in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo ìjà ogun tí èṣù fi ń dojúkọ ayé rẹ lálẹ́ yìí la ó ṣẹ̀ sí wẹ́wẹ́, a ó pa gbogbo ẹ̀rín lórúkọ Jésù.
Remember there is security in the refuge of God.
Rántí pé ìpamọ́ ń bẹ nínú ààbò Ọlọ́run.
Remember there is protection in under the mighty hand of the Lord.
Rántí pé lábẹ́ òjìji Olódùmarè ààbò ń bẹ níbẹ̀.
In Psalm 62 reading from verse 5.
Nínú orin Dávìdì. Orin kejìlélọ́gọ́ta ẹsẹ̀
karùn-ún. Psalm 62 reading from verse 5.
Orin kejìlé ní ọgọ́ta láti ẹsẹ̀ ìkarùn-ún.
He says, my soul, wait thou only upon God.
Ó ní ọkàn mi ìwọ sáà dúró de Olúwa.
For my expectation is from him.
Dúró jẹ́ de Ọlọ́run nítorí láti ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ̀ wá ní
ìrètí mi. You need to talk to your soul.
Ó yẹ kó o bá ọkàn rẹ sọ̀rọ̀.
That you will look away from every other kind of hell.
Èyí ni pé ó gbójú kúrò lára ìrànlọ́wọ́ kí ìrànlọ́wọ́ níbò míì.
Because our God is sufficient.
Torí pé Ọlọ́run wa tó fún wa.
His power will never fail.
Agbára rẹ̀ kò lè kùnà láyé
láyé. Are you sick?
He's
able to heal
you. Ó lè
mú ọ lára dáa. Are you oppressed?
He's
able to deliver you.
Are
you married and there is no child is able to give you a miracle baby?
And
the enemy is running after your life, he's able to silence them. He is your creator and he's your redeemer. That's why you said, my soul, wait only upon the Lord. My expectation is from the Lord. How many of you have expectation from the Lord tonight? And you believe it's going to take the problem away. You will not be disappointed in Jesus' name. In verse 6, in verse 6, he only, no one else, he only is my rock. And then he says, he is my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. You will not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength, my refuge is in God. Then he says, he was said, trust in him at all times. Tonight you can trust in the Lord. Tomorrow you will trust in the Lord. For the rest of your life you keep on trusting in the Lord. It says pour out your heart before him, because God is a refuge for us. I told you there are people, they will not trust in the refuge of the Lord, they are trying to make refuge for themselves. But what do they find? They find disappointment. Because in point number 2, insecurity in man's refuge. Insecurity in man's refuge. There are people that tell you that they have nothing to do with church. They have nothing to do with prayer. They have nothing to do with Christ. They have nothing to do with calling on the name of the Lord. They have nothing to do with going for a crusade. They say when there is trouble, they know how they get themselves out. It's all you people going to read the Bible and going to pray. It's because you don't know where to find real help. But when you talk to those people and you probe into their lives and you try to look at the refuge they are trying to trust in, you find insecurity in man's refuge. In fact, Isaiah tells us in a very dramatic, pictorial manner. Look at it in Isaiah chapter 28. Isaiah chapter 28. I'm reading to you from verse 15. Every verse we're looking at is very important. It shows that people trying to seek refuge for themselves, this is not the first time. They did it before. But there was insecurity, insufficiency in their refuge. It says in verse 15, because he
had
said, we have a covenant with them. That is, there are people that even say, what do you think about? We even have covenant with death, and we can control that time of death, and the death cannot come. They said, with hell we are at agreement. Obviously you are talking about the people that go into secret calls, the people that have some hidden agenda, and they see there's something behind the curtain they can rely upon. But then it says, when the overflowing scourge shall pass through, it shall not come upon us. That's a confidence they have because of the cockroach they bought, because of the lizard they bought, and they put into the skin of a dead animal, and they put on their waist, and they say, because of this waistband that we have, nothing that is going to come from the sky that we cannot overcome.
They
said, we have made lies our refuge. Under falsehood have we hidden ourselves. You will see there that actually what they are depending upon is falsehood And at the time they need that refuge and protection most, they're going to be seriously disappointed.
Iwọ no ri pe ohun ti won gba kale ni yi asan ati ekeni akoko ti won ba reti iranwo won ba ijakule
lagbade. But verse 16 it says therefore thus says the Lord.
Ni ese kan idi logun lo ti wa so fun pe nitori na bayi ni Oluwa
Jehovah wi. I lay in Zion for a foundation a stone, a tried stone.
Pe ki esi emi gbe okuta kakale ni Sioni fun ipile okuta ti
adewo. A precious cornerstone and a sure foundation, he that believeth shall not make haste.
Okuta igun ile iye biye ipile to daju eni ti o gbagbo ki yo sa.
It's telling you that you should brush aside all that refuge of life and come to the Lord, and then nothing will make you run. You'll be confident in the Lord. Your life will be secured and protected in Jesus' name.
Ohun to so fun gan ni pe gbogbo abo eke yi igi to fenti ti o le gbo duro yi ko kuro nibe bekele Oluwa yo si dabo bo ni oruko Jesu.
That means if you are coming to the Lord tonight,
ohun to tumo si ni pe to ba to
Oluwa wa to protect you,
pe ko Oluwa le dabo bo,
to defeat every Goliath in your life,
pe ko le se gbogbo
to remove every sickness in your life,
o le mu gbogbo aise kuro ninu aye,
every enemy has done in your life, to reverse every tonight. All the refuge of lies, you brush them aside. All those things you call savior that cannot save, you push them aside. All the tree you are leaning upon, but it's rotting inside and will fall, and you fall with it, you push it aside. In verse 17, judgment also, will I lay to the line? And righteousness to the plummet. The hail shall sweep away the refuge of lies. When the judgment comes, when the wrath comes, when all those troubles come, it will sweep away the refuge of lies. And it says, and the water shall overflow the hiding place. It says, if you don't repent, if you don't brush aside those things that cannot save, that cannot deliver, in verse 18, your covenant with death shall be
disannulled.
Your agreement with hell shall not stand. When the overflow is caught shall pass through, then ye shall be trodden down by it. Look at the pictorial language of Isaiah. All the people that think that they have anything that will secure them, the people that think that they are going to have any refuge apart from the Lord. Look at it in verse 20. For the bed is shorter than a man can stretch himself on it. That's the refuge of life. That's the refuge of the world. That's the refuge of man. It is like a 3-foot bed with a man like 6 feet tall wanting to lie on it. The bed is shorter than a man can stretch himself on it.
To je ni bese bata mefa to ba fesun lori ibusun ese bata meta.
Then it says the covering narrower than that he can wrap himself in it.
O tun wa so pe ati ibora ko ni obo.
It just tell you the insufficiency, the insecurity that people have in man's refuge in this world.
That
thing that cannot protect us, we're going to reject it. We're going to forsake everything. We're going to repent of the bad things we have done. All the things we're trying to use to replace God in our lives, we're going to throw them away. And then we will come to God. And we will tell God, in God is our refuge. In God is our protection. In God is our salvation. In God is our healing. In God is our deliverance. And when you come to put your trust in God tonight, you will see that all the problems the devil has caused in your life, everything will vanish away immediately, instantaneously, in Jesus' name.
O shawari pe gbogbo wahala ati isoro ti esu mu bo yo dopin lalaye ni oruko Jesu.
In Psalm 142.
Ninu orin David orin keji
le ni ogoje. Psalm 142 reading from verse 5.
Orin keji le logoje latese ikarun.
Psalm 142, let me back up to verse 4.
Je nka lati ese
ikarun. I looked on my right hand and beheld, but there was no man that would know me.
Emi wo awo atun mo si ri pe ko si enikan ti o mo mi.
Refuge failed me.
About death for me.
No man cared for my soul.
You
see, the refuge that people depend upon the world, it fails at a very critical time.
About an wey nyayen bekele.
And when things are right, the herbalist will tell you this thing will work like magic.
Your
cultic man will tell you this one will work. Just you know, strike this and touch that and say this, everything will be alright. But when the trouble really comes, you touch what they told you to touch, you leave what they told you to leave, you swallow what they told you to swallow. And you pronounce the incantation they told you to pronounce. And the devil said, you think that thing can touch me? There's only one thing that can conquer the devil. Christ at Calvary. The cross of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. All those other talisman, all those other things you are putting together, that thing can never touch the devil, can never scratch the devil. That's why the man said in verse 4, refuge failed me. And then he said in verse 5, I cried unto thee, O Lord, when all the refuge of the world, when they failed, when the power of the world, when it failed, when the reliance on the things of the world, when it failed, when he has spent his money and his strength on the thing that cannot deliver, when he had been terribly disappointed, he said, I cried unto thee, O Lord, I said, thou art my refuge. Thou art my refuge. How many of you are telling the Lord tonight is your refuge? It's your protection. It's your salvation. It's your deliverer. He is the one that will redeem you. You will not be disappointed in Jesus' name. And that brings me to point number 3. It's the sufficiency of God's refuge. The sufficiency of God's refuge. Tonight, I want to bring the Lord to you. And I want also to bring you to the Lord. And you will never regret the step you are taking tonight for the rest of your life in Jesus' name. If you will only believe on the Lord tonight, He will show you an immediate power, even right here tonight. You will find that the problems you brought in here, you'll drop it here before you go away. If there is anyone here that is lame, when we introduce the Lord to you and then you come to the Lord, the paralysis will get away, you rise up and walk. If you are blind, when we introduce the Lord to you and you come to the Lord, your blind eyes will open, you begin to see instantaneously. The sufficiency of God's refuge. You will not go back as you came here in Jesus' name. In 2 Samuel chapter 22, this man really knew the sufficiency of God's refuge. And he called the Lord by different titles. In 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 2, he said, the Lord is my rock. Then he said, the Lord is my fortress. Then he said, the Lord is my deliverer. Then he said, the God of my rock, in him will I trust. Then he said, he is my shield. Then he said, he is the horn of my salvation. Then he said, he is my high tower. And now he says, he is my refuge, my savior. Then he says, thou savest me from violence. He said, I will call on the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. That's your portion tonight. He will save you from your enemies. Can you see the sufficiency of the refuge of the Lord? Can you see as it says, when I think about the Lord, it said, it's my rock, the rock of ages. I hide myself in him from the storms of life. He said, "Is my fortress." He said, "When the enemies are throwing their darts and they are throwing their native bullet at me, and I hide inside that fortress, it will not strike at me. It will only strike at the fortress." He said, "The Lord is my deliverer. If the devil will take me in his jaws like a lion, and the thing that I'm going to be devoured and destroyed," he said, "the Lord will come and deliver me." He said, "This God of my rock, in him will I trust." Is there any sin in your life? In him will you trust for salvation? Is there any sickness in your body? In him will you trust for healing? Are you oppressed? Are you tormented? In him will you trust for deliverance? Then he said, "He is my shield. He shields me. He protects me. And all those things coming from the enemy will not get at me. It's the horn of my salvation." It's talking about victory there. It's talking about triumph over there. Then he said, "It's my high tower. It's so high, all those spirits, all those demons that are crawling on the ground, the serpents and the scorpions of this world, they will not be able to get to me in the high tower." Then he said, "It's my refuge, it's my savior. Thou savest me from violence." Tonight is that time for you. I said, "Tonight is that night for you." When we finish tonight, if you do what the Lord is telling you from here, if you will give yourself fully to the Lord, let me show you what will be the conclusion of your life. In Psalm 71 verse 7, if you don't have a Bible, your hand, write it down. When you go and check it up, and everybody will be checking up this verse to see that it is fulfilled in your life. In Psalm 71 verse 7, "I am as a wonder unto many." When you come into the refuge of the Lord tonight, you will be like a wonder unto many. Witches will look at you, they will wonder at you. Wizards will look at you, they will wonder at you. Abadis will look at you, they will wonder at you. The people that put a curse on you before, when they thought that you should have died because of the effect of what they put on you, and you are still alive, and you are still kicking, and you are still running up and down, and you are going stronger and stronger, all those people that put the curse on you, they look at you and they'll be wondering.
I want you to feel that you want to get good talent. Ti won reti ki won gbo ojo iku re ko ti ku nigba ti won ba ri o to je pe biri rologo re yi to je pe se lagbara re nle si lojojumo ti o nlokun si enu omo ya won.
Those who swore you will never have a child,
awon ti won ro wi pe o ni
when they see you having twins,
ti won ba ri to n bi beji
and having another one, so
tun bi mi
having another one, so tun bi mi, and you are telling God, "That's enough now, let me take care of this one."
So won pe awon ta fun mi yi ti to Oluwa
je so awon. All those who said they will never have a child, they be looking at you, you will be a one down to them.
Awon to wi pe o ni foju ri omo re laye yi enu omo.
But how can you be a wonder to the enemy? It's in that verse 7. "I am as a wonder unto many, but thou art my strong refuge." It is when you come to the refuge of the Lord, you'll be a wonder to your enemy. The sufficiency of God's refuge, there's salvation in that refuge, there's deliverance in that refuge, there is healing in that refuge, there is protection in that refuge, there is safety, security in that refuge, there is dominion in that refuge, there is victory, there is triumph in that refuge. You are wondering, how can I get into that refuge? In Psalm 91, Psalm 91 reading from verse 1, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my what?" I said, "It's my what?" He is my refuge. He is my fortress. My God. You see your God tonight? My God. You see your Savior tonight? My God. You see your Redeemer tonight? My God. Have you believed on Him tonight? Have you forsaken the devil? Have you forsaken your sin? Can you say, "This God is my God? In Him will I trust. And surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee. He shall protect thee.
He shall cover thee with his feathers.
With
under his wing thou shalt thou trod. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. You will not be afraid again of the terror by night, of the arrow that flies by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. A thousand shall fall by thy side. I thought you'd say amen. And 10,000 at thy right hand. It shall not come near thee. Only with your eyes you will behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. It's because you come to the Lord tonight. That's why the protection will come upon you. There shall no evil befall you anymore. Neither shall any plague come near your dwelling. Any plague there tonight, any sickness there tonight, any infirmity there tonight, I will call on the name of Jesus for you. Everything will vanish away. You will become a wonder. You will become a wonder. I want you to rise up. And you are going to tell the Lord, I want to be a wonder. All the problems of my life, all the infirmities of my life, all the heartaches that I have, I want everything to go away. This is your night, my brother. This is your night, my sister. For you to come into the refuge. For you to come into the protection. For you to make Jesus your Savior. Jesus your Redeemer. Jesus your Lord. Jesus the one that will forgive you. All the insecurity. The refuge in the world. The refuge of man. The one that doesn't have any sufficiency, any security. You will reject them. You will reject them. You will reject them. You will reject them. God is my refuge. Jesus is my Savior. He is my Redeemer. He wants to forgive your sin. He wants to change your life. He wants to drive the devil away from your family. He wants to drive the demons away from your life. All the evil personalities, he wants to conquer them for you. He wants to conquer them for you. When you make Almighty God your refuge, and all the refuge of the world, all the refuge of herbs, all the refuge of magic, all the refuge of sorcery, all the refuge of evil powers, of talisman, you pack everything together, you throw them into the sea, you burn them with fire, you come under the mighty protection of Jesus. Let him be your refuge tonight. 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 Forsake all those refuge, all the refuge of lies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Heads bowed and eyes closed. If you want to come into this refuge, but you cannot have the two together, you cannot have the security of the world and the security in Christ together. If you want to come into Christ, and you want God to be your refuge, and you are willing to brush aside and put away and confess and forsake all those things I cannot say, you raise up your hand now as we pray together. And as you raise up your hand, just quietly there, tell the Lord, I'm sorry for the bad things I've done. I'm sorry for the sins I've committed. I'm sorry for the evil I've done. I'm sorry for the juju. I'm sorry for the idolatry. I'm sorry for the occultism. I forsake them. I take
Christ as my Savior.
I come into Christ as my refuge. And I will not go back into my sins again. I will not go back to the refuge of the world again. Receive me now, Lord. Thank you for receiving me. I accept Jesus now as my personal Savior. Come into my heart. Come into stay. Thank you for answering my prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Keep up your hand as I pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for these, my brothers and sisters. They have heard your word. They know there is no security in the refuge of the world. And those things are insufficient when we need them. They have not forsaken them. And they are forsaking their sins too. And they are asking that you forgive them. In your love and mercy, forgive them in Jesus' name. Take their guilt and their condemnation away. Let the peace of God come into their hearts. Give them assurance that through the death of Jesus Christ, their sins are forgiven, their guilt is taken away, there is no condemnation anymore now. Receive them now in Jesus' name. Bring them into the refuge of Christ. Be their salvation. Be their refuge. Be their rock. Be their fortress. Be their deliverer. Be their redeemer. Come now in Jesus' name. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You will be a wonder tonight. When the sickness in your body vanishes away, when the infirmity in your life vanishes away, when God touches your life and something miraculous takes place, people will see you, they will wonder in Jesus' name. We are catching your miracle tonight. Raise up your hand. You are getting it for yourself, for your child, for your family. You are catching the miracle tonight. God is going to put a testimony in your mouth. Then you lay the other hand in the place where the problem is. Almighty God will come before you. I know you are a God that will never fail. We have come unto Christ, our refuge. And I pray that all the things that your people have suffered in the world tonight will be a turning point. You will cancel everything in Jesus' name.
You have
given us power and authority. And we pray, oh Lord, that power, that authority will work for the good of your people tonight in Jesus' name. I pray that every power of darkness, every evil personality, everything that is negative, everything will be subdued, everything will be conquered, everything will be overcome, even tonight in the lives of the people in Jesus' name. I pray that one by one you begin to touch them. The swelling in their body, whether it is goiter, whether it is hunchback, whether it is hernia, whether it is elephantiasis, I command now, come out in Jesus' name. Many months pregnancy, I command that thing melt away in Jesus' name. That insanity, that mental problem, that epilepsy, that evil spirit tormenting the head and tormenting the mind and tormenting the nervous system, I command you right now, come out in Jesus' name.
Ati gbogbo nti o ta ti gbe sibe to ti deri yi loriru nisisiyin mo gbadura pe agbara Olorun yo mu kuro mo pase e jade ni oruko Jesu.
Asthma, I command you, be healed in Jesus' name.
Ipo ti o wa nibe mo pase
e jade ni oruko Jesu. I command you right now, be healed in Jesus' name.
Oni ko jade jade mo pase pa be igba wo se ni oruko Jesu.
I command you, be healed in Jesus' name.
Ipo ati ogbe enu ti eni ni mo pase jade ni oruko Jesu.
The cancer that is eating up the body of that individual, I command the cancer germs die off, be healed in Jesus' name.
kokoro arun jejere ti se arun janajegun ti eni ni ni bayi mo pase ki o kudanu
bayi wo so bayi lorugo Jesu. I command that the Lord will touch that heart, be healed in Jesus' name.
Okay, eni ni to feju bo ti ye Oluwa fowo kan bayi lorugo Jesu.
The thing that is walking about, moving about in the body, making that person to feel like dizzy and fainting, I command that infirmity be healed in Jesus' name.
O ton wo kakiri to rin kakiri nu ara eni ni to dabi pe oyoju nko mo padura mo pase bayi wo so bayi lorugo Jesu.
Coughing out blood, urinating blood, be healed in Jesus' name.
Iko te eyan wu ton ko eje ati ito eje bayi
ko ku oporo lorugo Jesu. Breaking, almost breaking your head, be healed in Jesus' name.
Ako efori to fe le fo lori ni mo pase ko kuro bayi lorugo Jesu.
Lord, I pray for those that have internal disease, internal pain in whatever part of the body. I pray that right now, as they are touching the place, your mighty hand will touch the place to you. And that sickness, you have no right to be there. I command you therefore, whatever you are, wherever you are in the body, come out in Jesus' name.
Te eyan nku lo ninu sugbon to dabi pe nkan o se lode ara Oluwa mo gbadura pe ke fowo kan bi ti won fowo kan na eni na to je pe esun da loro to fe pa danu mo gbadura pe gogo n to wa nibe bayi jade nibe ni Oluwa Jesu.
Those who are married and they are looking for children, touch the husband, touch the wife. I pray that by this time next year they carry their miracle baby in Jesus name.
Fun gbogbo awon to ti segbeyawo ti won woju Oluwa fun omo e fowo kan oko e fowo kan aya ni iwoye amodu won yo ma gbe omo se yanu ojo Oluwa Jesu.
I command you right now, blind eyes be opened. Blind eyes, I command you, begin to see in Jesus' name.
Fun gbogbo awon to foju to wa ni lale yi gbogbo oju to fo mo pase riran eyin afoju eriran ni oruko Jesu.
Those legs that are paralyzed and lame, whatever it is, or whatever, a stroke or one short leg or withered hand, the power of the Lord, vitality from heaven to enter into your body right now, rise up and walk in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo iyaro, gbogbo ese riro, owo gbigbe, ibikibi to ti ku ninu agbara mo gbadura ki iye Olorun ati agbara jinde Kristi wobe e gba idande e
di bebere si ni lorugo Jesu. The spirit of deafness, the spirit of dumbness, I command you right now, come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo awon to diti to yadi, gbogbo emi yadi ati diti, e jade ni oruko Jesu.
Oh Lord, I pray that you confirm the miracle. As we open our eyes now, I pray they open their eyes to miracle. Open their eyes to healing. Open their eyes to deliverance. Confirm it in their bodies in Jesus' name. Thank you Lord, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray.
Oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
Amen.
Amen.